At last. I must say I'm disappointed in your progress. I imagined you'd be here sooner. Tell me, did it trouble you to murder your brothers?
Did it trouble you when you ordered me into the abyss?
Eternity is relentless, Raziel. When I first stole into this chamber centuries ago, I did not fathom the true power of knowledge. To know the future, Raziel. To see its paths and streams tracing out into the infinite. As a man, I could never contain such forbidden truths. But each of us is so much more than we once were. Do you not feel with all your soul how we have become like gods? And as such, are we not indivisible? As long as a single one of us stands, we are legion. Our futures are predestined. Mobius foretold mine eons ago. We each play out the parts fate has written for us. Free will is an illusion.
I found the tomb of Saraphan Cain. How could you profane a priest by turning him into a vampire?
How could I not? One must keep his friends close, Raziel, and his enemies even closer. Who better to serve me than those whose passion transcends all notions of good and evil?
The Saraphan were saviors, defending Nazgul from the corruption that we represent. My eyes are opened, Cain. I find no nobility in the unlife you rudely forced on my unwilling corpse.
You may have uncovered your past, but you know nothing of it. You think the Saraphan were noble, altruistic? Oh, don't be simple. Their agenda was the same as ours. This is not where or how it ends. fate promises more twists before this drama unfolds.
Redeemer and destroyer, pawn and messiah. Welcome, time span soul. Welcome to your destiny.
Soul I left behind.
You
deceived me.
All that we created.
Sanctuary is an abomination!
And our son.
I made it right. To satisfy the heavens.
Tell me, did they rejoice? No, they do not want you.
No! Ascend!
show yourself, Kane.
Here, Raziel. Everything is decided here. You cannot comprehend the magnitude, the rapture, and the tragedy of this moment. And yet you must. If Nosgoth is to be dragged from the wreckage of its damnation.
I understand only this, Kane. That you and Mobius have impelled me to this moment simply means I can trust neither of you. I don't know who's pulling the strings, but it no longer matters, because I'm cutting them. I set my own course from here.
If it were only that simple.
Your fatalism is tiresome, Kane.
And profoundly ingrained, Raziel. You must understand, our presence here doesn't alter history. You and I meet here because we are compelled to. We have always met here. History is irredeemable. Drop a stone into a rushing river. The current simply courses around it and flows on as if the obstruction were never there. You and I are pebbles, Raziel, and have even less hope of disrupting the time stream. The continuum of history is simply too strong, too resilient. Except, then how do we explain William here? The beloved boy king turned tyrant. In my youth, I witnessed William's rise to power and his transformation into the nemesis who laid waste to Nosgoth.
Keep your distance, Kane.
Years later, I stumble upon a chance to journey back in history, unaware that the entire affair has been carefully orchestrated by Mobius. In my wisdom, I seize this opportunity to murder the young king before he can ravage Nosgoth, and thereby provide the catalyst Mobius needs to ignite a genocidal war against our race.
I warn you, no further.
This one reckless act unravels the skein of history. The nemesis never becomes the nemesis. William dies a martyred saint. I, the vampire assassin, become the author of my own species' extinction, and Mobius profits from it all. I destroyed a tyrant only to create one far worse. But how can it be so? How, if history is immutable? The answer is here in this room, Raziel. Mobius propelled William and me together, but ensured first that we were both armed with the Soul Reaver. The Reaver is the key. Two incarnations of the Blade meet in time and space. A paradox is created, a temporal distortion powerful enough to derail history.
Is this your sorcery?
Not mine, Raziel. Yours. You have nothing to fear from me, Raziel. You hold all of the cards.
Then perhaps I should test your sincerity. If what you say is true, you should be terrified. I could kill you here and now.
And so you do, Raziel.
What's happening?
We're hurtling towards our destinies, Raziel. What you feel is the pull of history rushing to meet us. This is where history and destiny collide. If you truly believe in free will, Raziel, now is the time to prove it. Kill me now, and we both become pawns of history, dragged down the path of an artificial destiny. I was ordained to assume the role of Balance Guardian in Nosgoth, while you were destined to be its savior. But the map of my fate was redrawn by Mobius, and so in turn was yours.
This is madness!
Fight it, Raziel. This moment does not have to be an ending. It can become a prelude.
I can't.
You can, Raziel. Look inside and see that it is so. You have the power to reshape our inevitable futures.
Poor William.
What is this?
History. A pause, a paradox, Raziel. Even now, the time stream strains to divert itself, finding its old course blocked by your refusal to destroy me. The future is reshuffling itself to accommodate your monumental decision. This is where we restore ourselves, Raziel, and reclaim our intended destinies. It may yet be possible for me to assume my role as Balanced Guardian and return the pillars to their rightful inheritors.
To the vampires.
And this is the destiny you have urged me to discover. I don't know what game you and Mobius are playing, Cain, but I refuse to be your pawn. Unlike you, I still revere whatever shred of humanity I've managed to preserve. You will not use me as the instrument of your messianic delusions.
Very well, Raziel. I'll not ask you to trust me. Your truths are for you to discover alone.
Humble words for one who presumes to teach me a lesson at every turn.
And continue your journey and learn your own lessons, Raziel. Remember, Mobius led you here, but you walk away unfettered. A champion of free will and conqueror of false histories. There is much more for you to unearth, if you have the heart for the truth and the will to see it.
The dream they never forgave that became a cyborg with a Putin inside a network with a Putin linked up to a terminal with a secondary Putin eye. Opport relaying a signal to another Putin that was disguised as a John Connor alias who was working with a KGB spy code named Putin who was secretly a double agent for Putin who was the real Putin cause. After this whole Ukraine conflict, Putin wasn't sure Putin could trust Putin not to try and kill Putin to overthrow the government of Putin for Putin's own gain and rise to power in the ashes of Putin's death.